Daily Devotion with Pastor Balla for April 20th, 2021, from Luke chapter 16, The Greatest Gift. Previously, we heard Jesus teaching about the actions of an unjust manager who, knowing he was getting removed from his position, lowered the debts of his master's debtors so that the unjust manager would be gladly received into the people's homes. Jesus then continues in Luke chapter 16, verse 9, "And I tell you, make friends for yourselves by means of unrighteous wealth, so that when it fails, they may receive you into the eternal dwellings." You could say this is exactly what the unjust manager was trying to do: make friends using the wealth of this world. However, Jesus states that it will fail for a purpose, so that you may be received into eternal dwellings. What did Jesus mean? Just as the unjust manager wanted to be received into earthly dwellings, we should use the wealth, which, by the way, are God's blessings to us, to share those blessings with those around us, so that we don't get attached to those blessings. Because if we get attached to those blessings, we may miss out on the greatest gift, eternal life. Jesus will soon teach that the love of money or wealth separates us from God. But first, Jesus is going to teach us about integrity. Jesus continues in verse 10, "One who is faithful in a very little is also faithful in much. And one who is dishonest in a very little is also dishonest in much. If then you have not been faithful in unrighteous wealth, who will entrust to you the true riches? And if you have not been faithful in that which is another's, who will give you that which is your own?" What do we do with the many gifts that God gives to us? Do we use them faithfully and wisely? For how do we handle the gifts of God, like wealth, also has a relationship on how we handle the greatest gift from God, which is faith. We need to remember that faith is a gift, the most precious gift we will ever be given. St. Paul tells us in Ephesians chapter 2, verse 8, "For by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not of your own doing. It is the gift of God." Because faith is the greatest gift, Jesus now warns us that what may get in the way of that faith, and strangely enough, it is the other blessings that come from God. So Jesus continues in verse 13, "No servant can serve two masters. For he will either hate the one and love the other, or he will be devoted to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and money." Jesus teaches us that God's many blessings given to us may get in the way of the greatest gift, that of faith. So Jesus tells us to use the money and the other blessings from God to serve our neighbor, which, by the way, is also serving God. So guess what happens when those who love money hear these words of Jesus? From Luke chapter 16, verse 14, "The Pharisees, who were lovers of money, heard these things, and they ridiculed Jesus." Join me again tomorrow as we hear the response of Jesus to the Pharisees. God's peace and many blessings be with you, and thank you for listening. And please take an opportunity to share this message with others. If you have enjoyed these daily devotions, please consider making a donation to Peace Lutheran Church, 24024 West Main Street, Plainfield, Illinois, 60544. Thank you again for listening.